homeboys and homegirls, it's your girl. Shimmy. Yeah, y'all, you have to excuse me. I'm looking a little rough. It's been a long week, you know, at the work job place. Y'all, I had to wear a hat today at work because my hair is just, it's furred. Like, it's not my fake hair, not my weave, but my leave out, y'all. And I'm like, oh my god, it was 4:10 in the morning. So yeah, y'all, as I was saying before my phone dropped, it was 4:10 in the morning, and I could have sworn I went to bed with a scarf, but when I woke up, I didn't have a scarf on, and my leave out, it just was like all over the place. So I'm like, you know what, I don't know if we can be wearing hats all willy-nilly at work like that, but I know they allow us to wear like a green hat with a green outfit, you know, for kidney week or whatever, but that's only on Wednesday, and today is Friday, and I wore my green, and then I just put a hat on, y'all, because I'm like, I'm not fooling with this hair today. Like, it's too early in the morning, I gotta be at work at 5, I don't feel like sitting there making like I'm flat ironing some hair. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna put my hat on and I'm gonna see if I can get away with it. And lo and behold, I had my hat on all day long. Like, the patients there, they just thought I was wearing a hat just to be sporty or whatever. They was like, oh, you wanted to wear your hat today, be a little sporty. And, you know, they old or whatever, they don't know nothing. And I'm like, yup, I sure did, you know. But lo and behold, I wore the hat because my hair is jacked the fuck up, y'all. Like, the leave out is just a mess. So yeah, y'all, I got off early today. I'm supposed to work till 7:30, but I got off at 2:00 today. I called Bae up. See, she wanted to do something today since I'm getting off early, because she be going crazy when I gotta work them long shifts. So we don't see each other like all day on Fridays, you know, until I get home. Then we might watch like a movie, have a little, you know, excuse me, a little small date night or something like that. But I called her up and like see if she wanted to do something today, like maybe run out to some stores or just hang out. I don't know. We'll see when we get there, because I just got off the phone with her. Like, she literally called me soon as I walked out the door. Like, where you at? I said, Bae, I'm just getting off. Where you think I'm at? I'm getting in the car. So I don't know what we're gonna do today, y'all. But I thought if we do something, we should, you know, go ahead and bring you guys along. Wherever we look, I'm gonna stay in this lane because they be playing too much. Yeah, y'all, I'm about to get off this phone because it be hella traffic in the Baltimore area. So, and this angle is terrible, y'all. It looks like I got a little bean here with a big ass hand. But this is the only way I can keep my phone from falling on my phone mount. A little raggedy, but yeah, y'all. So I guess I'll holler at y'all when I get to the house. So what's up, homeboys and homegirls? I am just getting off of work, so that's why I look rough. I had a hard day. There's a lot going on, a lot of blood, a lot of running around, a lot of bleaching. Like, oh god, it's been one of those days, y'all. But yeah, finally freaking off. It's almost 4:00. I was supposed to be off at 2:00, so that goes to show you how my day's been going. And Bae been home sick, y'all. She been having like back problems and stuff, so she been calling me. I'm like, Bae, you know, make a doctor's appointment. If you don't want to make it, if you scared to make your doctor's appointment or whatever. A lot of people, when like they in pain, they always scared to make their own appointment, you know, just because they nervous of what the doctor might say. You know, I told her, you know, send me the information and I would definitely call and make a doctor's appointment. Then that's when she was like, no, Bae, it's okay, I'm gonna see if this heat and pad works. But if the heat and pad don't work, then I'll make an appointment. So I called her back like around lunchtime and asked her how she was feeling. And she was like, every time she walked, her back hurt even more. So I'm like, Bae, come on now. You need to make a doctor's appointment. You know, there ain't nothing to play with. You could have pulled a muscle or, you know, anything. So I'm on my way home. I'm gonna try to convince her to just go ahead and make a doctor's appointment. If she don't, I'm gonna make it myself. And yeah, so I might just stop at the grocery store, get her like some flowers or something that she like to eat or drink. Just something, you know, something sweet, you know. Just to make her feel, you know, just to make her feel better. Cause I know she in a lot of pain. I don't like when she in pain like that. So I'll probably stop at the grocery store, get her like some chocolate. She loves Symphony bars, y'all. So I might get her a Symphony bar, some flowers, and a get well card. Something cheesy, you know, when you just wanna make your boo smile and, you know, get her mind off of the pain. So yeah, y'all, let me get up off work ground before they call you and be like, well, Shamir, you think you can stay or something crazy like that, y'all. Let me escape while I can. And then there's a little daycare over here, y'all, where I work at. And they're so cute. Little kitties just running around playing outside. They look like they no more than 3 years old, y'all. They're so cute. Change of plans. I talked to C again, and she hungry. She hungry again. So I decided to get her some Chipotle because she really wanted some Chipotle. She didn't even ask me to get it, but she was talking about Chipotle. So I'm like, instead of the chocolate and stuff, I'm gonna just stop at Chipotle and get her something to eat. You know, food is a way to a woman's heart at the end of the day. You tell a bitch you going to Chipotle, oh my God. They gonna love you forever, sis. I'm gonna put my head on because my hair's a mess. Like, y'all can really see my hair. Ugh. Work be fucking... It be a lot going on. So, alright, y'all. Let me go ahead and get this chapato.
And who is they? That's why I keep trying to ask you.
Hey, y'all. I forgot to tell y'all that I got the Chipotle and that I'm home. I forgot to pick the daggone camera up. But I done bought the Chipotle up here, y'all. And I forgot to heat it up, so now I gotta go all the way back downstairs. About to tear it up.
Hungry.
Mm-hmm.
And then
when we came outside,
mm-hmm.
I was high
school,
really?
Yeah, 30
minutes. 7 minutes? That ain't nothing. Was you mad, Sandra?
Yeah,
because
there was nothing to do, too.
It was boring?
Yeah.
Oh, that sucks. Yeah, y'all, so I'm just heating up these bowls real quick, and then I'm going to get out these nasty work clothes, eat my food, take a shower, and I'm gonna finish watching Unbreakable. Anybody watching Unbreakable on Netflix? Oh my God, that show is so funny. So that's what I'm watching right now on Netflix, y'all. It don't take much, y'all. No sass. No asshole. Fix your shirt.
Yeah. Queens vibes. My fellow queens or whatever.
We had so much fun. Bree, did you have fun? Bree. You used to just slump. Look at Cutie on duty. Y'all know he is too cool for school. That's a grown man right there. You try to tell Sierra how you've been acting.
All right, y'all. I'm about to find somewhere for me to use the bathroom. Of course, I'm the only one who has to use the bathroom. Because I'm fucked up. Bring in your pee. Let me go find somewhere to pee, y'all.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was counting up like last week. Tell me, where have you been?